Hello and welcome to the 1999 Lindrum Masters. This week we begin the second round matches with Willie Thorne, who made a disappointing score in the first round. He's up against Cliff Thorburn, who'd also like to have gained a little more from his first round encounter. We join the snooker with the score at 0-13. Willie Thorne has just come to the table. Eddie Charlton is the commentator and Alan Gregory is the referee.
Opening the reds nicely. Another good safety shot. Putting the pressure on Willie. Would appear the red's on for the middle pocket here. Be a good one if he can pot it. Now, having missed, it's the first real chance that Willie's had to score. Pink's safe, but the black and the blue are both on, as is the green.
One.
Taking the green to position on the reds.
Four. Five.
Yes, there's a chance of building a reasonable break here now.
Thirteen.
Tried to spit the reds there with the cue
18.
Ball, but it hasn't worked out. I think he'll be forced into playing a safety shot now. Went for it. Difficult shot.
18, Willie Thorne.
But he knew he wasn't leaving anything easy, so it was worth a try, I suppose.
Thank you.
think he's left the red onto the middle pocket. He hasn't played that quite hard enough. It's not an easy one. Only half a pocket to play into at that angle, and White's a fair distance away, but it'll be a good ball if he can pot it.
One.
It's a good shot. He has an angle here to split those reds off the blue if he wanted to, but there's one or two reds that he can get onto without doing that. Yes, he's playing for the reds.
Six.
Didn't play that shot quite hard enough. Drawing one red onto the other here. It's a good shot. He's lucky that it was on.
Seven.
Now this blue's a big ball. If he can make this blue, he'll really have a chance of winning the frame. Prefers to take the yellow with the rest. Understand that.
Seven, Cliff Thorburn.
Was a more difficult shot than the blue was, but he's lucky that one red that was on, the yellow ball's covered it. There are two others there that's open, but neither of them easy. Oh, good shot.
One.
Very good position.
Six.
Play for the black off this red.
Seven.
Intended to pass around the black to be on it for the corner where he potted the red, but it hasn't worked out. But at least he has the yellow. It's on for the middle and it's on for the far corner, but it's a risky one to take on, because if he plays for a red at the same time and misses the yellow, it could cost him the frame. He went for it. It was a very good shot.
Nine. Ten.
That's a good one.
18.
Could win in the frame that shot.
It's up there, isn't it?
25.
'll be on the back blank if he pots the red.
26.
Now that last red will take some sorting out. It's not easy in the position that it's in. Intended to double the red past the blue to the middle pocket.
33.
I don't think he's in position to do that. White didn't travel far enough. No, he still went for it.
33, Willie Thorne.
Now a good red here from Cliff. He could clear up here. They're all on. 35 points on the table. It's enough to win by.
One.
Nesson is in very good position to do it now. Taking the cue ball from the blue to the yellow.
6.
Draw back off the yellow for the green.
Eight.
It's good position. Brown ball next. One's good position on the brown to get to the blue. It's not
what
a good
do you
one.
Do for a living?
11.
He's left himself a difficult brown, but he could still pot it.
Really? Do you think so?
He's making a joke of it, but he knows he played a bad shot there.
Thank God I can play billiards.
If he can pot the brown, he'll certainly be on the blue. But it's a risky one. Could cost him the game if he doesn't pot it. So close. Now we'll be lucky enough to have
11,
a snooker.
Cliff Thorburn.
Oh yes, look at this.
Just in case I miss.
Left the brown over the pocket, but managed to finish with a snooker. That was a very lucky shot. Unless Willie can hit that brown ball, it's going to be left on it so close to the corner pocket. He's in a lot of trouble here. But then again, if he could hit it, he might even pot it. Remains to be seen.
Can you spot it, please?
I think he's going to try and masse around the blue. That's swerving the white around the blue to hit the brown.
Foul. And miss. 5 to Cliff Thorburn.
I'd say that'll cost him the match now, or the frame. So that was a very lucky fluke snooker for Cliff. Travelled little further, he could have cut it into the middle pocket. But it now looks as if it has to be a very fine cut on the blue to make it. Now that's
nine.
A good shot. Perfect position. So he's won the frame. This is a big ball. Wins the frame. Should he pop this?
22, Cliff Thorburn.
The snooker goes to a second frame.
Willie Thorne, 51. Cliff Thorburn, continue on.
Cliff leading 58 to 51. The red is on to the corner. The black is on for both corners, so be a good ball if he can pop this one.
22.
Now, having missed it, he's left a good opportunity for Cliff. He had to take it on. Stunned through too far.
One.
It's a good pot, but he's left himself very difficult on the black. Where he might normally consider playing off another colour to get the wide ball to the far end of the table, this red ball up there, so he'll have to be very careful with this. In fact, I think he's going to take the black on. And it's certainly not an easy one. Good shot. We could certainly benefit from that.
Eight. Nine.
Good position again.
Sixteen.
Interesting to see which colour that Cliff plays for off this red.
Seventeen.
Had he positioned onto the blue, it would have been a chance to split some of the reds out, but he's not in a position to do that now. Playing for the single red. And this shot right along the cushion to a closed pocket
20.
Is not easy, particularly when he has to position the cue ball as well. That's a good shot.
21.
That's an angle on the yellow to force the yellow and spit some reds out with that cue ball. I'm sure he'll try it. There's nothing else on otherwise. That's the yellow. Now, how lucky is he going to be? Yes, he's on a red.
23.
In fact, he has the choice of two, one for the corner, one for the middle. So that worked out nicely. The red to the corner will be the easiest one to get onto the black. And the red to the middle, he could be on the pink, so has to make an important decision here. Wait for the pink.
24.
It's a good shot. Potting of the pink is not so difficult. It's positioning on the next red. He would like to have had this pink a little bit straighter to that middle pocket, but there's an angle to the shot. He's got to try and hold that white ball to be on a red after potting the pink. Well, there's nothing wrong with that. Tried to split some reds out, but the kiss on the red steered him onto the red above the black. Pink won't fit on its spot, so it has to go in a straight line to the top cushion as close as it can without touching a red ball. So that's pretty well tied the pink up for the time being. But the black's open.
30.
Might play for the blue here. It's a little bit strong for the blue.
31.
But he could still play the blue. Could have played it very gently for the black ball, but it's one of those shots that, should it fail, the red fail to go in, it would have been left right over the pocket for Willie. Now he's trying to hit those reds and bring some reds out. He hit them but didn't catch them full enough.
36.
Has the choice of two reds to the middle pocket, but neither of them easy. If he goes for this, it'll be a good shot. Particularly if he can pocket the red.
Cliff Thorburn.
He certainly has not left anything too easy for Willie either. Has the red to the corner past the black, but be a good shot if he can pot it.
30. Missed
it by quite a margin, but he hasn't left anything. Cliff leading 94 to 51. It's a big lead in a very strong position. 30. Shot, giving the white ball very close to hard up to the bottom cushion. Be trying for safety here. He'll open the reds up in doing so.
Slow down, baby.
Now the reds are on for opportunity to make a big break, but it's it's Willie that needs them, not Cliff. Cliff only needs a few points now. Don't think he'll run the risk of trying to pop one from here. Cliff will be looking to play another good safety shot here. In fact, I think he's looking at playing two reds onto a third red for the corner pocket. No, managed to miss. But he's certainly not leaving Willie with many chances. Only needing 14, 49 points. Cliff only needing 6 points. A red, a blue, a pink, or a black would do the victory for Cliff. The balls are in a position for Willie to make a big break, but he's got to get the first red, and there's certainly nothing easy from this position. And he knows that he certainly can't leave anything on for Cliff, or it's the end of the snooker match if that's the case. So he's got to play a really good shot here. Oh, and it's a good pot.
One.
There's no colour that's easy, but the blue to the corner, if you can pop this, there's several reds on. No.
One, Willie Thorne.
Not to be, not on that shot. The black's reasonably safe. Even if Cliff pots this red, he's going to find it difficult to be on the pink as well. So he's going to have to play a good shot.
One.
Now this pink's a big ball. Yes.
Seven on the
snooker
and
the match. Great
shot. So the lead is 48 points to Cliff Thorburn going into the billiards. In fact, Cliff Thorburn won the billiards as well. At the end of the first two disciplines of the Lindrum Masters, the score is Willie Thorne on 109 and Cliff Thorburn 200 points. In the eight ball pool, we join in the third frame. The score is 1-1. So the overall difference remains the same. I'm in commentary with Jim Rempe and Angie Charlton is the referee.
You're going to try to put a lot of power into this. Warm up. Yeah. See, he elected to hit the second ball, which is a good break because look at the balls he's made here. And when you hit the second ball with the cue ball on this kind of with that break, and you see the movement you get on the eight ball, where the eight ball is all the way up table, you have a chance to make it when you hit the second ball. He's got choice now because he made a few different balls. Actually, you get choice anyway if you make anything. Yeah, that's right.
You could sink two stripies and still go for the the smaller solids.
There's so many different rules in this eight ball. He's got to break this brown up. He's going to try to do it right now. Just draw it back into it. Now he's tied it back up. No. He's going to try to make the two ball on the corner. I don't know what he's playing for position. The three goes in the corner pocket down here. But what good is it? You know, if you can't break him up. Unless he's looking to cut this three back in the other corner and let the cue ball come across the table and back into the 9-7, yeah. Just come across the table.
Oh, boy.
I can't tell what he's called it in that corner. So he's cutting it thin and letting the cue ball come over to the cushion here and then back over to the 7 and 9, trying to break him up.
Ooh. Well,
he made the pot. I mean, even though it hit the cushion and went in.
Good luck. I don't know what to do with it.
What's his best option here?
I would cover the pocket with the six. I would just try to lag the six to the hole and just leave it in the hole and make him so he's got to make the eight in a different pocket.
No coaching.
Well, they're having a good time out there, aren't they?
Yeah.
Unless he tries this screw back here and go into the seven. I mean, that's going to be an incredible shot if he does that. He's going to try it, too.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, baby.
Well, actually, he wound up in a pretty good spot. He can hit the seven anyway. I mean, and try to do something with it.
Yeah, it's a party, eh, Willie? He's throwing a party for you.
You better pot it, mate.
Well, I'm going to pot it. I just don't know where you're
Where's going yet?
Where are you at? I could figure. Well, I could go one.
Uh-oh. They're going to get the three. Map out here.
Oh, Hollywood. Yeah. Is the tape on?
Yeah.
Just wondering.
This is the map back to Toronto on this shot.
All right, I was in the side.
The thing is, if he pots it, he has to nominate the pocket.
The old double kiss shot.
Yeah.
He can't just hazard it.
What's that, Jim?
Quiet, Jim, quiet.
Yeah. Actually, you know what, ain't a bad shot. I mean, if he can shoot the blue, or the blue stripe, just commit a foul on purpose. And knock the 10 and the 13, the orange stripe and the blue stripe out of there so that he don't have a ball, so Willie wouldn't have a ball to break him with. So this doesn't get him no offense. It's no offense here.
Yeah.
So what Willie can do right now is just to take the initiative and play a safety and and yep, play the safety. Play a safety. Try to keep Cliff from hitting a ball. Try to keep him from hitting the seven. Now, if Cliff fails to hit the seven ball,
anybody could have done that.
Willie gets cue ball in hand.
Yeah.
So then he controls the game.
Anybody.
Me even.
That's what's wrong with taking your balls off the table before and not getting all the way out.
But the interesting part of the tactic, you're saying he would have been better off in that previous shot, hitting his opponent's ball.
Yeah, just taking the deliberate foul, knocking the 10 and the 13 out of there so Willie wouldn't have a ball to break that cluster up with. See, those two balls there act as a good shot to break the cluster up with when Willie does get to the table. You know, three fouls in a row in this game, you lose the game, too. See, this is no good. There's a follow now. Now, Willie, all Willie has to do is take the cue ball in hand, put the cue ball on the other side of the nine ball, and just follow the nine up to the thing and make him get three scratches.
So what do I do now?
Well, you get your ball in your hand.
Yeah. Can I put one of his balls? Can I put one of his and that counts as mine? That's a foul or not?
No. No, he's asked the question.
Your ball first is not a foul.
See, he can just roll up behind the nine. Just in pool, you have to play. You have to hit the ball and then the cushion. He can do that right here. He can't make his ball. No.
I can still carry on once I pop the ball.
No, he can't.
No, you have to pop one of your balls.
Oh, okay, that's what I was saying.
Yeah, yeah. See, but he doesn't know. I mean, the safety strategy on is on here. Three scratches in a row is loss of game. So all he had to do there was just roll him up behind the nine. He elected to run out, but it would have been a lot easier to just to get the guy in three follows and not even have to take any chances.
Shatsky.
Now he's taking a chance. I mean, even if he misses up here, I mean, Cliff's not going to have a shot at the seven, but it does give Cliff a chance.
Well, he'll probably clear the table.
Yeah. Well, he probably will, but, I mean, he didn't have to take any chances there. No, he's just shooting every ball and stopping the cue ball dead. That's a good pattern. Uh-oh. You're a little out of line here. No, he's made it tough on himself.
Willie Thorne, two games to one.
Here we go.
Jim was saying I should have played the snooker.
No drop.
Yeah, six is still rolling. Nope. No drop. Yeah, it looks to me like he's going to take the high balls. And again, the 12 ball over here on the cushion is going to be a problem, but he can shoot the 15 right now and then get the 12 out of there with the very next shot. Just follow over here and get the right kind of angle on the 11 ball. He didn't get the right angle on the 11. Now he can't get into it.
No.
See, now he's mad. Now he's digging a ditch. He's getting himself in trouble. You got to get that ball out of there.
Keep doing this to myself right away, you know? Only yeah. Trouble after one shot. You know?
See, he understands it now. The more you play this game, the more you dig that ditch, the more you say to yourself, I can't do that again.
So now he's got to make something out of it.
Well, you got to get to it as fast as possible. The more balls you take off the table in this game, the less chance you have of winning if you don't open up that problem ball.
So what's he got in mind here with the nine and the...
Well, the 14 goes. If he hits the 14, comes over here and gets position and then makes the 14, the nine's going to come down on the cushion. It's going to give him another ball to break them up with. So I think I would. I mean, if you're going to commit to running out here, I mean, you go up and play the 13 next. You play go up and play position on the 13 in the side. I see, because there's not a lot of shots to get position on the 13 in the side. That's why I said it. Well, he's got position on the nine here. Actually, I mean, it's not a bad shot because he can make the nine, then use the 14 to break up the 3 and 12. You know, he's going to shoot this and get an angle on the 14 ball, and then break up the 12 with the 14, if he doesn't scratch here. Oop. Now he's going to shoot the 14. Shoot the 14 and break him up. But when you break balls up, you want to come into them, and like here, you're supposed to come behind it. Just make the ball here. I think he's going to just see what happens. Yeah, hit him. Hit him and go find him. That's a golf shot, isn't it? Hit him and go find him?
Yeah.
See, but now he's tied up. That's what I'm talking about right here. Now he's tied the 12 up in a different area. You know, but he's only got, I mean, he started the... He's
moving him around all right.
Yeah, but he's in trouble. He's looking to see if he can make the 12 out into 6, you know, at the same time like he did the other one. I don't think that's on this time. Yeah, I don't think this shot is on this time. Maybe it is.
Because of the position of the 6.
Because of the position of the 6. You're going to get the rebound off the cushion and give the double kiss there and make the 12 stay there. See, and then if he cuts the six, that's no good because naturally the 12's just going to go in the middle of the table. See, I don't think this shot is on.
Is he better taking 13 and coming?
Well, he's dead. I mean, he's got to go for this now. If he does, if he does miss the 12 ball, it should stay there and block the five anyway. See what I mean? The double kiss was on. And now it's
not in hand, am I? Just play from here.
It's wide open for Willie. I mean, Cliff has done this two or three times now. Just left it wide open for him.
If Willie wins this game, he'll have an unbeatable 4-1, 100-point lead.
Well, he needs to get some big points back because, like you said, he's lost the snooker and the billiards.
Well, he's got the clearance going here. They're all in good shape.
Just play for the one ball down the corner, and then it's just to stop the cue ball there for the blue two on the side. Or you can shoot the blue right now, yeah. Watch it here. He can get behind the 13. No, he's okay. He's perfect.
So Willie Thorne wins the eight-ball pool.
So Willie Thorne gets back 75 points in the eight-ball pool. He still trails on 184 to Cliff Thorburn on 225 going into the deciding nine-ball pool. We join the nine ball in the third frame. Once again, the score is one each. I continue in commentary with Jim Rempe, and the referee is Angie Charlton.
Exhausted.
And he scratched.
Oh, come on.
Can't be lucky all the time.
Yeah, right.
Look at the balls. They hardly even move.
Yeah.
Willie.
Oh, I wrapped them here, sorry.
Yeah.
Four's gone, is it?
No, the four is pink. This is just tapping around the... Around the pack here. He doesn't see the four. He's shooting at the orange.
He's
shooting the wrong ball. Foul.
Foul shot.
Why?
It's a four ball.
Which is the four?
Pink one.
Oh, okay.
Sorry, William.
Thanks for telling me.
Well, you know.
I mean, he should have known that because when...
Was I supposed to tell you that you're shooting the wrong ball?
Well, Jim told Eddie. I don't know what the rule is. I've no idea.
No, you're not supposed to tell. It's a foul anyway. That's why I asked Jimmy if he wanted me to call it and he didn't.
I had Jimmy call it twice on Eddie. Okay, fine.
Okay. I'm in the middle here.
I'll have a shot, Cliff.
Well, yeah,
now he's making Cliff feel bad because Cliff did tell him, and I told Eddie.
Yeah, you know, I don't know the color of the balls. I don't play.
Yeah, well, you know, I don't. It's the first time I've played these colors.
They've got numbers on them.
Well, I mean, it's not the... I mean, you're supposed to take care of yourself. You're 21 or whatever, and you're supposed to take care of yourself, is what it is. But Willie's seen me do the same thing with Eddie Charlton, and I told Eddie what ball to shoot. But I shouldn't have told Eddie what ball to shoot because it's... I mean, you're out on your own out there playing. You're not supposed to rely on anybody helping you.
I've often thought in snooker particularly, where there are no numbers in straight snooker, if you're colorblind, you can have a lot of trouble with the green and the brown.
Yeah,
at least they've got numbers in this game.
Well, like I said, we don't have a pink four in pool in the States. I mean, the pink is only for the television. The pink looks like the brown seven here. I mean, in the States, it would. the brown 7 would be maroon instead of brown. So it gets confusing when you're out there and you're not used to playing with them. But we've been playing on a lot of television matches. I was in Warsaw, Poland, and that was televised. That was a pink 4. And then we played in Wales. That was a pink 4. So I'm getting a little used to it. But I had problems with it myself.
Just slide this in to take a 2-1 lead in the 9 ball.
He slid it in there.
Listen, I hate playing with friends.
Another valuable 25 points to Cliff Thorburn's coffers. However, Willie Thorne wins the next frame to even up the 9 ball at 2 frames all. Overall, the Canadian leads on 275 to Willie Thorne, 239.
I don't know what he's trying to do here. I mean, he could play safe off this one. Or try to make the orange ball, or cut the 2 back in the corner pocket. He's trying to cut it and make the... That was a good shot. I mean, it was a two-way shot. Mm-hmm. Two-way shot here. He's got a combination on the 2-9 here. I mean, it's straight on. I mean, all you got to do is hit it straight on. It's a tough shot, but it's a makeable shot. And his only shot.
So the 2 onto the 9, that's the game. If he can pot it.
And see if he hits this soft or rolls it. See, I would jack up and hit this hard. By jack up, I mean elevate the butt into the cue. He's just going to roll this ball. Overcut it. See, that's what he just said. Jack up, hit it hard. That's what you're supposed to do. You can't roll that kind of shot. You got more accuracy when you hit it hard.
So I don't know where that goes or not.
He's looking to see if this blue kisses off the brown in the side pocket. And I didn't think it was on. But he was playing safe at the same time. And it's a good safe.
Each way is special.
See, you can make the 2 ball here, but it's very tough to get down table for the red 3. It's a shot that you have to shoot. Here's another shot where you have to jack up and hit down on the cue ball, but it makes the shot very tough. And plus, you got to hit it with a little left-hand English. So you're hitting down on the cue ball with left-hand English, which means the cue ball is going to swerve on the way to the blue 2. He's not even going to attempt that shot. A pool player would, though. Because it's the only shot.
Yeah, Jimmy's gone. He's gone south with the voice now. I can't hear him anymore.
Yeah, he's looking for me to tout him. Yep, there he is. That's the shot.
He's heard something.
But I don't know what he tried to do though.
Well, that's a goodie.
I don't know if he was trying to make the ball or what. But he got lucky with the safety.
Don't worry, I'm not going to go to the race, right? Well, I should, actually. Yeah.
You know, don't worry. As much as these guys are joking back and forth, they know this game is close. They know the score of the snooker and the billiards and the 8-ball and the 9-ball right now. It's very, very close. And each game now means whether you win the match or not. And you want to go into your next match being on top. You don't want to be fighting back.
Hmm.
I don't know what I can't see what kind of angle he's got here. No.
Well, was he thinking of playing it onto the 9?
Yeah, I think he was trying to play a combination or something.
Hmm.
Now, this is a funny little shot because he can get position on the 3, but he wants to get an angle on the 3 to get up for the pink 4 after the 3. So, I mean, and there's only a little space to get between the 6 and the cushion to get position on the 3. So, to shoot this shot, you want to be on the bottom cushion. You want to have just that shade of an angle here. Just on the bottom cushion you want to be. You got to shoot this shot and freeze the cue ball to the bottom cushion. If it's not froze... He got it froze. See, so he's got that little bit of an angle on the three to get out. If it bounced, you know, that half an inch, I mean, then he would have been in trouble. It's a game of inches, millimeters. So he's going to spin this ball with a lot of right-hand English, top right-hand English. It should spin towards the, but that's it. That's what he had on there.
Why is it top right-hand English?
We call it that. I mean, it's spin, or we call it English in the States.
As in foreign?
Yeah. Like this shot, he's going to screw back. We call it a drawback.
Yeah.
Yeah, he didn't want to be on the cushion in that shot. He's okay, though.
Drawback, something to do with a cigar.
Well, yeah, or a pencil.
Well,
see, he's got to hit this
lucky?
Thinner than he wants to. I mean, you got to kill the cue ball on this kind of a shot, so you have to skid the cue ball into the six.
I like this game.
But that way, and he's going to have to elevate the butt into the cue stick to do that. And when you do that, it makes the cue ball jump. So you're going to hit a different part of the green that you think you're going to hit, because the cue ball is going to be jumping into the green. There's a lot of funny things in this game that the more you play it, the more you find out that what's in it. He's hitting it with a level stick, so he's going to try to go around the table. He's going to hit this hard. Oh, look at this shot. He used the black to stop the movement of the white, which is an incredible shot. I don't know if he played that, but if he did, it was one heck of a shot. They're smiling. I don't know if he tried it or not, I think. But he made a good shot anyway.
He got the result.
We'll go all the way then.
He played for the black in the other bottom cushion or pocket, but he got it in the top pocket. And he'll be pleased with that, I guess. Draw back, over for the nine, same pocket.
Cliff Thorburn, three games to two, leading in the nine ball.
And that pushes Cliff out a bit further. He now leads by 61 points.
Well, he hit him pretty good.
Lots of movement, nothing down.
Well, Willie's got a great opportunity here. I'm sure they're both weighing up the numbers in their mind, you know? I mean, they know what they want, what the score was in the billiards and the snooker. They have to know that this... Well, maybe they don't know. This is... If Willie wins this game, the next game's going to be for the whole set. How do you like the pressure?
That's it, the pink. Got the right one.
He's got to get an angle on the green six to get back up table for the brown seven. See, that's what he's looking at right now. He's got to make sure he gets an angle. Oh, he got a big angle, right? He didn't get a shot on the six. Yep, he overdrew the ball, and then there's no shot here now. He's got to play the safety. He squandered a very good opportunity to clear up the balls there.
Safety battle, Willie, shall we?
See, here's the shot here. I mean, if he hits this ball to the bottom pocket and goes two cushions, he can hide the six behind the black is the right shot. It's not that difficult either, because you just hit the six over to the bottom cushion, remember, the bottom cushion to the side cushion, and come two cushions with the cue ball. It's a real easy shot, actually. Oh, that's no good. Yeah. He went for a bad percentage shot.
Cue ball's supposed to come around over here. Go, Harry.
Look at this. He's going to... Ooh.
I know what I'm doing. It's the others.
No, he's got a tough shot here. He's got to go for the shot. He's got to go up and down the table now. You hit this ball with a center cue ball. Just let the cue ball go up and down. He elected to go in here. this, but he's going to wind up getting in trouble. Well, he's got to come with a good shot here now. He's got to elevate the butt into the cue here, too. I mean, this makes it a tough shot. Big pockets. But he overhit it again.
Yeah, this is a test to finish with.
Well, he's laughing, but see, you wouldn't shoot this shot. You would play safe off this one.
Leave me a bank. That's the key.
Oh, well, yeah, but you never miss banks.
Huh?
Rest, please.
Where do you play safe?
Well, you just thin it and put it the same as you would do in the snooker. Thin it and put him up table. Let him take the bad percentage shot on the bank. But these pockets are so big, you might want to shoot the bank.
Go on, show me a bank.
It's over.
Well, no, he's actually left us in a good position because the bank is not on. He can't make this bank, I don't think, because the kiss is on.
Oh, one time, baby.
He can't make this bank.
For the gipper.
No, the kiss is on. He can't make this bank. See, it's laying right where it's where he can't make it. The cue ball can't get out of the way with the right angle. I don't think. Maybe from up here it looks this way anyway. No, he did have room. He did have room, and he left him a bank.
What do you do? Natural double?
Well, I would play safe, just put it on the bottom cushion. You know, I mean, they're taking bad percentage shots. The whole game is a game of percentages.
It's rare you see them take as long to get rid of the last ball.
Well, but they're shooting bad percentage shots. Yeah. Well, this is the shot you go for. You got to go here, but...
That's a putt.
They should have been playing safe. With all their snooker knowledge and everything, they should have just went for the safeties.
And that's the game.
That was the game right there. That was
it. 4-2 to Cliff Thorburn. And as a result, he takes the match 325 points to Willie Thorne's 259.
Next week, we have Oliver Ortman up against Australia's own Eddie Charlton. That's something to look forward to next week. I'm Jim Maxwell. Bye now.